Well, four of those former cheerleaders are with us exclusively now. Ainsley Parrish, Hannah Turnbow, Kelly Nooner, and Ashley Rodriguez, and Gloria Allred, their attorney, joins us now as well. Ladies, good morning. Thanks for being here.
Good morning.
You talk about a hostile work environment. Ainsley, what does that mean? How were you treated?
It's very, very uncomfortable on a daily basis. They body shame you to your face. They body shame you. They are extremely bullying tactics, and they instill this fear in you that they hold your entire success and opportunity in their hands. Anything you do or speak up against them, you're learned and taught not to.
Body shame. Mm-hmm. What does that mean? What words would they use?
Jelly fat, bellies.
Fat, skinny.
You're skinny fat. Mm-hmm.
Skinny fat.
All of this, you guys, it sounds like a lot. The NFL makes a ton of money. The players make a ton of money. Betting is now going to be legal. It's a wash in money. You guys make $7.25 an hour. Why take a job that pays $7.25 an hour?
I think when you go into it, there's a lot of, I don't know how to explain it. You know it's a good opportunity to get into your community. They make it seem like it's just such a dream on their social medias. You don't sign up for something and think it's going to become what it was.
And especially for you, you describe a time where they would have the cheerleaders kind of go up into the stands with the fans and interact. And at one point, a fan put his hand on you. What happened?
Yes, so I was filming for Jumbotron. We do giveaways in the stands. And we have a safe word, Toro. And a fan was running up the stands at me. And I was saying, "Where's Toro? Does anyone see Toro?" And no one did anything. And by the time he got to me, he put his hands in between my collarbone and my shoulder and pulled me down a stair. And I said, "What are you doing?" He said, "I'm trying to hug you." Mm-hmm. And I told my alumni that was with me, and nothing was done. We went straight to the next place and did another appearance. Mm-hmm.
The Texans say they did stop having cheerleaders go out and go in the stands after that incident with you. Mm-hmm. What about the pay issue? Because as I understand it from your lawsuit, it's not just that the pay was low, which presumably you knew when you signed up for it, but that you weren't paid for hours you actually worked. Is that what happened, Kelly?
Right. Yeah. And I think, you know, I didn't know necessarily what they were doing was illegal as far as not paying us for certain things. We kind of were just in a kind of a, we're young, and they kind of take a little bit of advantage, I feel like, of us because we're young and we're women, to just accept that there's certain things that we have to pay out of pocket and not be reimbursed for.
And just Ashley, I think a lot of people, when they see cheerleaders, they think, wow, they go out and dance and have fun and so what? But there's a real training regimen that goes into this. This isn't you show up and put on a routine.
Absolutely. So outside of all of this, we are professional women and we have something so much more to offer. And so this takes years of practicing. I mean, I've been dancing since I was 4 years old. So it really is a lot. And being when you think of NFL cheerleading or, you know, any major league that allows cheerleaders to be a part of their team, it's the highest of highs for us. It's the elite level of dancing and cheering, everything that we wanted and trained for our whole lives. So, yes, there is a lot of training and preparation that goes into it. And when you go and once you're a part of it, you expect these great things. And unfortunately, we were disappointed through that experience.
Gloria, what do you hope to get out of the lawsuit? Because some people say, look, it doesn't pay a lot, but you know what you're getting paid. So, you know, it's a free country.
Well, they're not told what they're going to be paid until they're selected out of the more than 1,000 who try out and then about to sign the contract. But they're paid minimum wage $7.25 for maximum effort. And as you pointed out, as you both pointed out, they're not even paid for quite a bit of the work that they do. They're not paid for many of their practices. And they are not reimbursed for many of their expenses. So they're being cheated out of that minimum wage of $7.25. And by the way, this so-called adjustment that the NFL has said that they're making, you know, they didn't get security when they went out for appearances in the community. Mm-hmm. And the NFL makes a lot of money from this cheerleader package, sending some of the cheerleaders to some of the high-end suites. The fans pay for that. they're only getting $7.25. That's unfair. We're going to deliver a letter to the NFL office today and ask the commissioner, Commissioner Roger Goodell, to really make changes in all of this, because this is unfair to these young women. This is sex discrimination, and it's time for there to be fairness and equity and stop the exploitation of the cheerleaders.
Well, out of time, I got to leave it there. But ladies, thank you for being here and telling your stories. Gloria, thank you as always. Appreciate it.
Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.